So we gradually moved on. There'd be one course after another, but basically the evenings, all evenings were started with marching and precision, and we learned to salute, of course, and then eventually, as time passed, the first requirement is to take basic training, and the basic training then was HMCS Cornwallis for everyone. So we went by train to Cornwallis, which was, I would never have gotten there otherwise, I guess, but we had the usual, again, more marching and basic courses in the rules and roads of the Navy. And I think that went well. And when we came back, we were back at Discovery, and I was enrolled in the TAS department, which was torpedo anti-submarine control. And we were taught by the various sailors on what that was, which was underwater radar. And that took place all of the first winter, I guess it was. Then the second year, there was an opening at several openings for Wrens that wanted to volunteer for special duty at HMCS Star in Hamilton, Ontario. And that was conned, which was the head office of the Naval Reserves for all of Canada. At that time, we had 23 Naval Reserve depots across Canada, like Edmonton, Calgary, Saskatoon, Regina, Winnipeg, and several in Manitoba, and several in Quebec, and the Maritimes, of course. So my next trip was to HMCS Stadacona for further training, and we were actually taken out onto the areas where the men had trained during the war, which was detecting ships that came into Bedford Basin. And I think we'd go out for the day and take along they'd give us cooks who gave us wonderful, hefty meals, and thus went Stadacona. They were quite strict there, and a lot of high-ranking men of the Navy were stationed, of course, in Halifax, because at that point, the threat of hostilities in the Pacific were still very evident in the theater of war over there, so they kept... We would be taken on, our sea time was day trips on one of the small HMCS ships out into the Great Lakes. Well, that was great for us, we thought. We'd sunbathe on the deck. And so I spent several months at HMCS Star and then came back to Vancouver and carried out my, I did make one more trip back to Stadacona for training because at that point I had the TAS division for the Wrens was discontinued, and I went into the meteorology department, which was starting out very new, and of course meteorology then was very, very basic, but it was very interesting, and I really liked that. But my five-year term had come to an end. Also, by that time, I was married, so it wasn't always just so easy to get away and take the required 2 weeks training, which would have taken place over at HMCS Naden in Victoria, or be sent east. So at that point, I left the Navy.